you want to call them a dynamic duo or maybe double trouble. They've been called that, I'm sure. One thing is for sure, these two comedians definitely bring the fun.
That they can, and they're doing just that at Chuckles Comedy House this weekend. But first, Huggy Lowdown and Chris Paul are back with us. Gentlemen,
y'all are looking good.
Good to be back. Good to be back. Good to be back in Memphis.
Look comfortable in those chairs over there.
These are the most comfortable chairs.
We like the sunken place chairs.
We did a live morning show in Detroit. They had lawn furniture out there for us. This is too nice.
We're trying to take care of it. We're trying to take care of it.
You see now, peaches and her.
That's it. Peaches and her. Now you are taking us way
back. Well, they haven't kicked us out yet. Y'all are still grinding it.
So what's been happening with the two of you?
We still here. We're trying to unite America through laughter.
Well, how's that working for you?
It's not working too good.
We're losing.
Not good. We had a couple.
We try to make America laugh again.
Some people laugh. Some people tell them, send them back.
Send them back. Have you gotten the
camp? Why are you talking about your neighbor like that, bro?
I would wear that cap, if you go online, sell Make America Laugh Again.
But even my wife now, I think my wife is a Trump supporter, because every night in bed she builds a wall of pillows between us. She built a wall. I can't even get to her.
The wall is there. Is this a good time, though, for comedians? Because it seems like the material is out there, no matter your politics, on a daily basis.
It's more of a struggle, because every day it's like, it's not funny when it feels like some people are getting hurt.
Yeah.
You know, and there's a lot of things going on right now where people...
But they need laughter now.
They do need laughter.
More than anything.
The best thing is to distract them from what's going on versus constantly taking what's going on and throwing it at them. So we like to go out there and have people come out, get a couple drinks, get a good meal, like at Chuckles Comedy House, and just take your mind off all your problems and everything. Let us do the heavy lifting and driving, and just have some fun. That's all we're trying to do.
I'm always curious, because y'all take comedy from everyday life.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Are there any cities you've played where it's just, like, really boring and it's hard to find anything funny?
No. We find there are good people
everywhere.
Especially, like, Tom Joyner listeners. I don't know what it's about. Maybe it's just Tom. It starts at the top. Tom, the people who listen to Tom Joyner are just such good people,
good,
caring
people.
They want to hug you and break you after a show. I mean, they're just great people. So
how many years has it been for you, I mean, being affiliated with Tom?
On Tom, I think this is now like my 8th or 10th year. He's two
like
more
10.
Than that. So I'm 10, he's 12.
I'm 12. 12 years on radio.
Wow.
And Tom is signing off.
Yeah.
At the end of December.
No, that's hard to believe.
So y'all hiring around here? Somebody to clean up, somebody to carry equipment for Bobby Rash? What do y'all need? What do y'all need? We can do it.
He's in the other studio right now.
We can take it. When you guys first started working together, did you just know instantly it just clicked? Because y'all have a real good shtick going.
But at the same time, you have two totally different personalities.
Right.
So
how
does that kind of come together then?
Chris is like a madman. He's like a mad genius.
Well, one of the reasons we do work so well together is because, like, if you come see our show, we are totally different. So even though we have common ground on our different ideas on the world, and how we like people and care about people, when you see our material and our delivery, it's completely different.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, we think different.
You're funnier, right? That's what you were going to say. He was just about to say that, Huggy.
Tell Kristen.
You're going to tell him that.
You were.
And you see the look on his face right now.
I don't know, Chris. I'm not so sure, Chris.
He's like a genius.
I'm a genius.
You must owe him money.
Well,
we owe each other money.
Yeah.
We borrow from each other.
Yeah. So what is it like to be back in Memphis, Tennessee?
Oh, man, I love Memphis.
We had one show last night. It was packed, man. Great crowds. And we're doing it again. We have something
special. Great food, too.
Right. We have two shows tonight at 7:30 and 10:30. But we know Tom Joyner's listeners, like, they're adults. They're adults. A lot of them are adults.
Okay.
So Saturday,
adults.
They're the kind of adults who don't like to go out and hang out till midnight.
Not like my grandmother.
No, not your grandmother.
My grandmother's still young, though.
I know.
She got a tattoo of Scatman Crothers.
Oh, no, she did.
Well, you are taking us back.
It's hard to see it because she's swinging on that pole so fast.
Oh, really?
But Saturday we're doing a matinee show for grown people who really want to go out, but know you can get home and be there for the kids. So we have a show Saturday at 4:30.
That's different.
Okay.
We'll be there.
I'm sorry, 4 o'clock and then 7:30. 4 o'clock Saturday, 7:30 Saturday, then back again at 8 o'clock on Sunday.
At Chuckles, that's for sure. Gentlemen, thank you very much.